If you can spot an easy zero of a polynomial, usually plus or minus 1 or plus or minus 2, you can use long division to factor this easy zero out. After this division, you are left with the product of a linear factor and a polynomial which is 1 degree lower than the original one. And this can make a big difference because factorization becomes a lot easier if the degree of the polynomial becomes lower. In this video, we will see an example of this procedure where we'll turn a polynomial of degree 3, which is hard to factorize, into a product of a linear factor and a quadratic polynomial, which is much easier to factorize. So we have the polynomial p of x equals x cubed plus x minus 2. And we spot a 0 because if you plug in 1, x equals 1, we get 1 plus 1 minus 2 equals 0. So we see that p of 1 equals 0. So that we know that we can factorize our polynomial p of x as x minus 1, a linear term, times q of x, where q is a quadratic polynomial. And now we want to find q of x. Well, q of x equals p over x minus 1, so equals x cubed plus x squared minus 2 divided by x minus 1. Okay, but we want to simplify this. How can we find q of x? Well, we learned how to use long division on polynomials, so that's what we are going to do. So we put our x cubed plus x squared minus 2 here and divide it by x minus 1. And we will use long division and we know that we are going to end up with remainder 0. So let's start. How many times can we fit x minus 1 into x cubed? Well, I can do the x squared times and we get x cubed minus x squared, which we put over here. And the x squared goes over there, the result. And then we subtract, we get the x squared minus minus x squared, so that yields it 2x squared. And we have a 0 times x, which we add, so we get 2x squared plus 0 times x. How many times can we fit x minus 1 into 2x squared? Well, we can do it 2x times, then we get a 2x squared minus 2x, and we put the 2x over here. And we subtract. So we get 2x squared minus 2x squared equals 0. That's of course how it works. And we get 0 x times x minus minus 2x yields 2x. And we add the minus 2. So we get 2x minus 2. How often can we fit x minus 1 into that? Well, we can plug it in 2 times. And we get a 2x minus 2. We subtract and we get 0. Which we should have gotten 0, of course, because we know that we can factorize p like this. If we would have gotten a remainder, then we would have gotten something like 2 divided by x minus 1, which blows up if we plug in x equals 1, and that's impossible, because plugging in equals x equals 1 should yield 0. So you know beforehand, if you do everything correctly, that your remainder is going to be 0. So now we have factorized p of x, like this. And x minus 1 times x squared plus 2x plus 2. And now the factorization problem has become a lot easier. If we are using only real numbers, then here it stops, because x squared plus 2x plus 2 does not have any zeros, discriminant is negative. If we can use complex numbers, we can go one step further. So we call this x squared plus 2x plus 2 q of x, and we want to factorize that into linear factors, so that means that we have to find the zeros of x squared plus 2x plus 2 equals 0. From now on it's standard. Complete the square. X squared plus 2x equals x plus 1 squared, because if you work out the brackets you get x squared plus 2x plus 1, and we have a plus 2. So we have another one equals 0. Put the plus 1 to the other side, then you get x plus 1 squared equals minus 1, so x plus 1 equals plus or minus I. So you have two zeros, x1 equals minus 1 minus I, x2 equals minus 1 plus I, and we can factorize q of x. Q of x equals x minus x1 times x minus x2. And then, as our final step, our total factorization, p of x equals x minus 1 times q of x, so equals x minus 1 times x minus horrible complex number times x minus some other horrible complex number. And there we have our full factorization. If you can use only real numbers, then your factorization ends here, where you have a product of a linear term and an irreducible quadratic term, And if you can use complex numbers, your factorization ends here. Then you always have some product of linear factors.